Grove, South Australia, and head towards Adelaide as we continue our journey around Australia for aspiring parasailers. As we cut up around past Kangaroo Island and back in towards Adelaide, we'll be there for about 4 days before we prepare ourselves to make a journey across to Port Lincoln. Do the work. Unfortunately, with a south-easterly wind and a south-westerly swell, and I'm heading in a north-westerly direction, it made for a roly-roly start for part of the journey, and here we are rolling away as we make our way northwest. So here we are, under sail. Doing a bit of a downwind sail at the moment, and I don't like it, so I've angled off a bit. This rocking and roll, the wind's doing that and that from behind. Have a look at that. We have a southwesterly swell. What are you doing, mischief? Captain Mischief, he's a good girl. What are you doing? Mentally speaking, I've not been in the best place. places mentally, and me, I'm putting myself out here, mm-hmm. letting people know what my weaknesses are. It takes some strength to let everybody know what your weaknesses are and embrace that. As much as it's a struggle, I embrace my abilities. You know, depends on your point of view. We've got something over there, I don't know, it might be land. And when you're rocking a passage, it does make for a challenge. Right. Yeah, that was a good one. I'm now going to do some prep work here. Oil, a bit of ground pepper, a bit of garlic powder, might need a bit more oil. Okay, right now, so I'm on passage and it is probably a lot easier to use stir fry Chinese veg. Got all the good stuff, you know, you gotta have your veg. Then when you add the purple cabbage and all that, that's what can happen when cooking on SV Skis. You can get a good rock and roll and swell and it'll just come and knock you for a six if you're not careful. I figured this would be a good opportunity to give people a look what it's like to literally chop up, cook up on a boat. I mean, the last video when we were coming across Bass Strait, that was basically convenience cooking. Purple cabbage, gotta have the purple. I love my purple cabbage and spinach on SV Skis. Cornerstone of a healthy diet. Tuck your fingers away when you're chopping up on a boat, rocking to and fro. Otherwise, you'll have those fingers. You'll end up cooking your fingers up. Guaranteed that, people. Guarantee that. Yeah, definitely one big clove of garlic. Throw that back in there. Alright, take the ends off, as you do. Right, next. Spinach. Now, the meat. Packed up into little servings, so I can get two servings out of this. So I don't overfeed, I don't overcook. I'll just throw that away for tomorrow. That'll be tomorrow's mince will go into lunch or something. Okay, just very quickly clean up so I don't have a lot of rubbish. There we go. Alright, that's that. Alright, it's cheap and nasty, but works. And besides, the sour cream and chives. And Captain Mischief and I, we love sour cream and chives. And we love spinach. So we've got to start happening here. Alright. When I was a bad little boy, that was the most useful tool in discipline. No, 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 don't be a naughty willy. Anyway. Yeah, that'll do. Alright, that's preparation for the meal on SV Skis. This is going to be a lot more interesting when I get into the global solo challenge, trying to cook while really in the swelly sea down the middle of nowhere. I wish 23 was now so I could go start this race and sail around the world for parasailing. As rough as it is, rocking around like this, this is fun, you know? Best roller coaster in town, and you get to cook on your roller coaster. I'll just let that all sit and simmer for a moment. Enjoy me cup of tea for a moment, check on things, keep an eye on things. That's how it's done on SVCs. Just woken up, made a coffee. Captain Mischief wants to be in the video. Come on, you know you want it. Every time there's a video, you get all excited. Anyway, we've covered some fair bit of ground. We're currently tracking towards just between Kangaroo Island. A very important thing about sailing around anywhere in the world is keeping a logbook of details of what's been going on. Oh, coffee. About 9:30 in the morning on Sunday here. So effectively, people, Captain Mischief and myself, over the last 3 years, have officially now circumnavigated one third of Australia. Had no idea what we were doing, no idea where we were going, just went and bought a sailing boat, headed to Great Keppel Island, and here I am now in South Australia 3 years later, circumnavigating Australia and the world, and the global solo challenge is a given. Where Captain Mischief and myself are the only ones ever to enter a race solo with a dog. How awesome's that? Out here sailing around Australia for disabled sailors, promoting the Parasailing Fund, which is hosted by the Australian Sports Foundation and managed by Disability Sports Australia. Anyway, there's your rant. Go out and make a donation! How are you, Thor? This is Captain Mischief. We're on SV Skis. Yep. we're on SV Skis. And we are sailing around Australia, promoting a cause that I started out doing back in New Year's Eve this year, called Solo Sailor for the Disabled. Now, what this basically is a national sort of pools fund where every dollar over $2 is tax deductible, and then it goes into a national pool fund where at a certain point we divide it up into grants and or donations to particular sailing clubs that provide aspiring sailing and parasailing programs, sailability clubs, etc., etc., people with a physical or mental disability that wish to aspire to parasailing. Now, I've been at it for 3 years. I've been sailing now for about 3 years. Yeah, this is my third boat. This SV Skis here. I've only just come into the YouTube thing because at that point, I have to use YouTube to promote what I'm doing, to get it out there, to show you people what it is that I'm all about and what it is that I'm trying to achieve. Now, at the end of the day, I'm not on a holiday because I'm not stopping around exploring locations and that sort of thing. What I'm about is about sailing hard and as fast as I can, promoting the Parasailing Fund to whatever port I can pull into, and giving my dog, Captain Mischief, land time with her toys, because she's really got a ball thing, haven't you, Captain Mischief? So, Adelaide. 6 months, 7 months into the journey. We started out on Solo Sailor for the Disabled, Newcastle, New Year's Eve on SV Skis. We sailed down the east coast of Australia, across Bass Strait, which was hairy at best, into a place called Binlong Bay, where there's a nice swing mooring. And then from Binlong Bay, we sailed down the east coast of Tasmania, around the peninsula via Fortescue Bay, Port Arthur, New Bina, into Hobart, and then down on the other side of the Derwent River, into the channel, out past Dover, Southport and all that, and along the south coast around West Cape, South West Cape, which I think should be included in one of the, you know how you hear about the races around the world, the non-stop? Well, I'm entered in the Global Solo Challenge, me and Captain Mischief. And I reckon South West Cape should be included into one of those, you know, three capes that should be called four. Anyway, yeah. So then I sailed at the west coast of Tassie into Georgetown on the north coast. Got my yacht out of water. Go to Facebook, SV Skis, and have a look. You'll see all the photos and some information. Then got back in the water. Kind of had, like, because of my mental issues that I have, I kind of had a struggling moment, and then I left and sailed off. I sailed a week and a half ago. I sailed off on a Friday and sailed all the way to Robe, South Australia. I left Robe, South Australia on Saturday, yesterday, and now I'm almost in Adelaide. I'm then going to continue sailing west towards Port Lincoln, and then after that, way across the Australian Bight, how's that? Non-stop to Esperance or Albany, and then to Perth, and then up the west coast, across the top end, down the east coast of Australia, then get ready for the Global Solo Challenge, all while promoting the Parasailing Fund. Now, I'm on a disability support pension. I'm not asking you to give me money, okay? What I am going to ask is that you go out and make a donation to the Parasailing Fund. I am going to ask you, would you be interested in advertising on my yacht, becoming part of SV Skis' long-term 10-year commitment to devoting his resources, his energy, his abilities to sailing around the world in global non-stop races and sailing around Australia, promoting Disability Sports Australia, Parasailing Fund, Australian Sports Foundation, anybody wishing to get involved in parasailing. Now, you know, sailing's a beautiful thing. It's done me wonders. You know, my mum left me enough coin to set myself up on this beautiful yacht, SV Skis. I'll just give you a bit of a twist around, okay? Just a make this video a bit interesting. And this is also good because I get to show you the radar, I get to keep an eye on that. Down there's my rear berth, the galley, dog food cupboard, of course, and of course back to me. Alright, so I'm going to continue on my journeys for 10 years. I'm going to keep struggling to do this on my own, but I need some serious assistance out here, people. I need team members. I need committed people to helping change people's lives. I'm into helping... That's the wrong word. Look, I'm into everything that I'm doing out here. I'm trying to change people's lives through the parasailing fund, make sailing more accessible. I wish to eventually, hopefully, have some people on board who are land-based, who are willing to commit as much as they can energy-wise into connecting me, helping me promote the Parasailing Fund and Disability Sports Australia, as well as seeking sponsorships for the eventual Global Solo Challenge in 2023. Also, you know, any donations actually given cash to me to support me or advertisement on the yacht, percentage of that, an agreed percentage, will go to the Parasailing Fund. The remainder of that fee will then go to supporting and getting skis around the world and Australia promoting the Parasailing Fund for the next 10 years. So that's really what it is. Here I am in my comfy recliner on SV skis. Thanks, Mum. God bless her cotton socks. Can't keep talking because I've got to keep an eye on things. It's like 9:30 at night, and like I said, we're coming into Adelaide, and it's obviously going to be a bit of traffic. Nighttime, unfamiliar port harbourage. Keep your toes and your wits about me. Well, that's what sailing's all about, isn't it? It's not like you can just jump in a car, you know, out there, no one's going to come and fix your flat. You get a flat tire, figuratively speaking, it means you're sinking, mate. You got a hole in your boat. Anyway, alright, look, enjoy following me. Please like SV Skis. Please like Solo Sailor for the Disabled. Please subscribe to this channel. Go out, make a donation to the Parasailing Fund. It's all $2 and above tax deductible here in Australia. Okay? Alright. Stay safe. Stay tuned as we prepare ourselves for the next stage of the journey as we continue sailing around Australia for the Parasailing Fund. So go out, I challenge you to make a donation and help me change someone's life.